In 1977, Europe's leading horror director completed a project that would propel the genre into new heights of cinematic sophistication. That director was Dario Argento, and the movie was Suspiria. By using radical elements of colour, lighting and sound design, Argento claimed that Suspiria would propel the genre to a new 400 degree centigrade experience.
It's useless to try and explain it to you. You wouldn't understand. It all seems so absurd, so fantastic.
However, Suspiria's extended and excessive scenes of female suffering meant that the film was praised and condemned in equal measure. By considering both the creative and controversial aspects of Suspiria, we will discover whether the film did indeed achieve Argento's ambition to film fear at 400 degrees. With Suspiria, Argento combined avant-garde film style with shock tactics to create an epic European nightmare that remains as influential as it is unnerving.
I saw it on a double bill with Zoltan, Hound of Dracula, which was the British release title for a movie called Dracula's Dog, which was just about what you imagine it to be. And the contrast between the two films was so immense that, yeah, even the stuffiest of film critics could see that. In many ways, Suspiria is a film critic's film because it is absolute cinema.
When I saw Suspiria, it was the first Dario Argento film I ever saw, and I watched it, and the opening scene frightened the living hell out of me, and I couldn't fathom why, but I sat there completely rigid, and I was both mesmerised and hypnotised.
When I first saw Suspiria, it was quite amazing actually. It was a mind-blowing experience, I can say that.
Continually through the film, I found myself in these situations that were inexplicably terrifying, but that were also compelling. And it was like a dream, it was like a nightmare, it was like a fairy tale, and it was also like something that was seducing me and making me suffer at the same time. So it was an intensely masochistic experience.
It's a great way to make a Dario Argento film. It is a great Dario Argento film. It's the absolute pinnacle of his career.
In contravention of the settings that dominated contemporary European horror cinema, Argento located Suspiria within a Baroque ballet academy where the students are being dispatched in bizarre and grotesque ways. The infamous opening of the film juxtaposes the arrival of the heroine Susie Banyan, played by Jessica Harper, with an extreme murder of a female student who has discovered the dance academy's dark secret.
Well, actually, for me, the beginning of the film, when Jessica Harper arrives at the airport, I mean, it really starts from that moment. I mean, I think that's a magical moment when she comes out into the torrential rain and trying to get a taxi, and then with the taxi driver initially being incredibly unhelpful, as very often they are. And then the ride to the academy, and sort of not seeing things in the woods, but you think you do. And we then instantly go to the girl that we see running away, but then we see her arriving at her own home, and everybody knows what goes on from there.
Che poi ho fatto un inizio che mi raccontava Sergio Leone, che quando era stato in America aveva letto nella autobiografia di Samuel Goldwyn. Allora fece che dice c'è questa riunione importante, Samuel Goldwyn deve parlare a tutti. E allora tutti andarono nel suo studio e riempì lo studio di tutti questi scrittori. E se vi ho convocati tutti, dice, perché vorrei dirvi una cosa. Ho avuto l'idea per un nuovo film. Ah, tutti, ah, interessante, interessante. E cos'è questo film? Dunque, il film comincia con il vulcano Krakatoa che esplode. Ebbene, il film che io ho in mente di fare è tutto di più. E allora tutti rimasero ghiacciati, anche se capirono il simbolo, che cosa voleva dire. Che lui voleva dei film che fossero un crescendo, ma forte, ma molto forte. E allora mi venne in mente questo episodio di Samuel Goldwyn e ho detto, adesso lo voglio applicare anch'io. E infatti ho fatto l'inizio del mio film, che dura, mi pare, 16 o 18 minuti, che è sempre un crescendo, è un crescendo senza mai fermarsi, fino a che non viene uccisa quella ragazza impiccata nella sua casa. È un crescendo assoluto, poi da quel punto in poi si calma il film.
That is all within the first 10 or 15 minutes of the film, and it never really lets up. So I think he actually ticked every box when it said, you know, what can we get out of this particular sequence in terms of tension and fear and shocks.
Even before Suspiria, Argento had created a series of cult European masterpieces that had revolutionized the Italian giallo or murder mystery format.
Sì, in quegli anni il giallo è stato importante, quindi perché apportava qualcosa di nuovo, qualcosa di importante, di fortemente nuovo.
Dario was the first that started with the Italian giallo, and I think that Dario was a master over the world of this kind of genre, because he changed the way to do a thriller and horror, you know. After Hitchcock, maybe Dario is the master.
These innovations in both content and style were evidenced in Argento's first giallo, The Bird with the Crystal Plumage.
When I saw the first film of Dario was in 1970, it was The Bird of the Crystal Plumage, and I remember I was shocked by the film, because I thought it was a wonderful film.
The film's shocking finale revealed a female killer mistaken as a victim of male violence. The film also provided an element of gender subversion for other directors to follow. Following the success of The Bird with the Crystal Plumage, subsequent gialli often recast women as powerful and punishing characters.
Ebbe anche influenza sul cinema americano, sul cinema francese. Non parliamo del cinema italiano, che da quel momento fece moltissimi film gialli.
Although often dismissed for their lurid titles and excessive violence, the giallo also reflected some of the social, cultural and political turmoil that gripped Italy during the 1970s.
Periodo era il periodo in cui ho cominciato a fare i film. Io era un periodo di grandi turbulenze politiche in tutta l'Europa, in tutto il mondo. Si era nei primi anni 70 quindi c'era una sorta di ribellione dei giovani, una ribellione che era sotto l'aspetto politico, ma culturale, musicale, del vestire.
As a genre, the giallo are completely involved in the specifics of their time and place.
There was a historic period in the late 60s and early 70s where Italian citizens had a very intimate relationship with the ambivalence of violence. And this was symptomatized by things like the Brigate Rosso, which was a group that was considered terrorists because they abducted a politician, and they were also some people that people from the South and also students and the disenfranchised could sympathize with. So it's the ambiguity of violence in that politic that was seductive, I think, to the Italian people.
When we say Italy in the 70s, what springs to mind is like the Red Brigades, financial corruption, governments changing every 20 minutes, all this kind of stuff.
Io penso che se non avessi fatto il cinema, io sarei finito male, sarei finito molto male, sarei finito in prigione, o sarei anche morto, perché ero molto coinvolto nel movimento che c'era in quegli anni. E chiaramente sono stato, io ero figlio della mia epoca.
As well as reflecting these social and political tensions, the giallo also drew on long-standing fears between Italy's urban north and the much maligned rural south.
The rural south in Italy compels a fascination because the majority of gialli were made in the north, and also in terms of an industry in Rome, which was a burgeoning new industry, and it was an industry that had money. And there is a fear in the south that the lack of capital also breeds a kind of monstrosity.
The giallo frequently acknowledged this southern monstrousness by having its hapless males travel from the urban north to the rural regions to uncover a perverse secret that compels the killer's quest.
A lot of the mise-en-scene in the giallo that are set in the south are very arid, very overlit, and also they exploit the superstitious nature.
While Argento's earlier giallo clearly reflected 1970s Italian concerns, Suspiria found him negotiating a new transnational and transgeneric terrain.
Quindi avevo un background differente dagli altri registi e mi ero creato questo mio spazio, questa mia che è stata penso la fortuna poi dei miei film, che è durata qualche anno, poi dopo è cambiato.
The earlier film of Dario are more giallo, Italian giallo. Suspiria was the first film of Dario that became international, you know, no nationality. It's not a typical Italian film, Suspiria. That's why maybe Suspiria is the most famous film of Dario everywhere, because he shot it in Germany, in the Black Forest, but it's a place that doesn't exist, you know. It's a school in a wood with the witches, and there isn't any kind of nationality, no Italy, no Germany.
What he does in Suspiria, he breaks with Italy as a setting. I think it's his first film not entirely set in Italy. He breaks with Italians as characters. I assume some of the characters in the film are Italian, but they never actually say they are. And we're in a completely different sort of set of cultural reference. And at the same time, he also breaks with rationality.
But what does it mean to be a witch?
Well, as a believer in the material world and a psychiatrist to boot, I'm convinced that the current spread of belief in magic and the occult is part of mental illness. Bad luck isn't brought by broken mirrors, but by broken minds.
As well as trailblazing a transnational approach to terror, Suspiria also saw Argento using experimental forms of lighting and color to achieve new heights of horror.
Well, Suspiria created a form of Italian horror that was completely different, primarily because it was not afraid to renegotiate things like narrative and character by privileging incredibly intense elements that are purely cinematic, such as sound and colour.
It never followed any sort of direct storyline. It jumped all over the place, but it worked. And that was the exciting thing.
It might be interesting to see that if you took the script of Suspiria and put it through, you know, the Robert McKee factory, what would you get? You know, what is Susie's arc? She goes from somebody who doesn't really know what's going on to someone who still doesn't really know what's going on, but is alive when no one else is.
And then, of course, there was the photography. I mean, it had the most wild, crazy colours, reds and greens and blues.
In Suspiria, io e Luciano Tovole volevamo rifare un po' come il Technicolor americano degli anni 40 e 30, 40, insomma, fine 30, 40. Da John Ford ai cartoni animati di Walt Disney. Vogliamo fare quel colore così potente, così forte, così acceso.
We often talk about how one uses a camera for a film and a brush for a painting and a musical instrument for a song. However, in terms of this film being poetic, I think what we're seeing is the collapse of the medium for the expression of the art.
Vogliamo rifare tutti questi colori, vogliamo rifare l'oro, che tanti anni non si faceva il color oro al cinema. Vogliamo fare il rosso, che anche il rosso è difficile a farsi, è molto complesso.
What Dario Argento has done is he's painted because he wants to saturate us with a kind of painting intensity. And so for that reason the colour is incredibly important.
Alla fine venne in mente a Tovoli di usare una pellicola a bassissima ASA. E siamo tornati andati in America a cercare la Kodak, e la Kodak non aveva più stock di questa pellicola, di questa sensibilità. E però ce l'aveva un laboratorio, trovammo un laboratorio nel Texas che aveva uno stock di pellicola di a 40 ASA. E la comprammo tutta, però era poca, era pochissima pellicola. E allora fu un problema perché adesso dovevamo girare e dovevo girare pochissimi Chuck, perché se no non era, mi finiva subito la pellicola. E quindi il film, io ci ho messo molto tempo a farlo, a 14 settimane, però in realtà giravo due Chuck solamente. Quando poi andai a montare il film, lo montai in due settimane perché avevo pochissimo materiale girato, quindi lo montai in due settimane solamente, lo montai e fu un film di cui sono molto affezionato.
While Argento's use of colour gave Suspiria a new level of intensity, his use of camera movement also gave the film an experimental edge.
Una volta io, quando facevo ancora il critico, feci un dibattito con Pasolini, io dirigevo il dibattito e c'era Pasolini e parlava, rispondeva alla platea, no? E io gli chiesi, siccome lui aveva scritto un saggio, aveva scritto che esistono due tipi di cinema, il cinema di prosa e il cinema di poesia. Il cinema di prosa è quello dove la macchina da presa non si vede mai. Il cinema di poesia è quello dove la macchina da presa si vede moltissimo. E allora gli chiesi a lui, essendo un poeta, pensavo che mi avesse risposto in un modo, gli chiesi, lui, dico, tu che film fai, di prosa o di poesia? E lui mi disse, io faccio un cinema di prosa, perché da me la macchina presa non si vede mai. Dopo, quando cominciai a fare il cinema io invece capii che io facevo un cinema di poesia, dove la macchina presa è molto presente.
It's obviously a film with showy technique. It's not ashamed to have elaborate, lengthy tracking shots, unrealistic but beautiful art decor, lighting effects, sound effects. It's almost through composed in terms of music.
Suspiria also saw Argento working with some of Italy's most respected and avant-garde musicians, including Claudio Simonetti.
I was a big fan of Dario, and when I did Deep Red, it was the fifth film of Dario. So I was very lucky. Very, very lucky to work with him, because with Goblin we were an unknown band, very young, and Dario chose us like he was a big and very famous director.
Ma tutti i musicisti quando lavorano in un film aggiungono, cioè, perché sennò il film sarebbe senza musica, va bene lo stesso. E invece aggiungono perché danno danno una piacevolezza di atmosfere, di una, sono molto importanti.
The big success we had with Profondo Rosso, Deep Red, in 1975, and Dario Argento shoot Suspiria. That was a completely different film style from Deep Red. No more giallo, but something like witches and magic is so. And Dario say, okay, I like your music now. Now we try to do something different. And I want Goblin again for the work. And we saw the film, and Dario say, okay, I want something that will scare the people. For all the film, I want this kind of, I'd like that the people feel like witches are still on the film, even when they are not on the screen, but people had to feel that witches are present, sono presenti, no? They present every time. we start working in a studio for almost four months, doing experimental with ethnical instruments. We use Indian tabla, sitar, bouzouki, Greek bouzouki. I use a big moog. And many kind of noises, like plastic glasses, vocals. Was very funny, interesting work.
I think that was probably the thing that people took away from Suspiria, was the music. It was actually unusual for music in a horror film to be so up front, so foregrounded.
More than any other film in the history of cinema, dare I say it, even more emphatically than Ennio Morricone's work for Sergio Leone, the soundtrack to Suspiria is inextricable from the images. If we talk about Suspiria being a painted film, we also must talk about it being an oral film.
There is a real feel of music isn't just complementing the images here. I mean, music is a good half of this film. In the way that, in the 1970s, they talked a lot about rock opera. So maybe that is what we've got here. Argento didn't need to make a film called Opera afterwards because he'd already done this.
Even now, after more than 30 years, I think that Suspiria has a fantastic soundtrack, maybe the best we did, very modern.
While Argento's use of film style achieved his ambition to frame fear at 400 degrees, his excessive use of female suffering also created new levels of controversy for Suspiria.
Dario, in every film, he invented some different kind of murders, and especially in Suspiria, is the beginning with the girl when she breaks the glasses and falls down, and with the heart with the knife, it's very impressive, very violent, yes, and but it's necessary in this film, you know, of course. Without, it's not be the same.
The treatment of women in Suspiria is it's always going to be an issue with Argento. Is he personally or are his films misogynist?
Sì, io sono stato spesso accusato, ormai da qualche anno non più, accusato di misoginia e di uccidere le donne nei miei film. Nella verità, naturalmente no. E questo è una cosa molto sbagliata, perché è stata un'interpretazione sbagliata del film. A parte il fatto che io sono abbastanza equanime, per cui uccido ugualmente uomini e donne, però si vede che le donne, per un mio interesse maggiore, le uccido, le faccio morire in modo più spettacolare. Questa è semplicemente la cosa, però non io rigetto completamente il fatto di essere misogino. anzi sono amante delle donne, non a caso quasi tutti i miei film sono protagonisti, sono donne, sono quindi o giovani donne.
I find that Suspiria is sort of glamorous about the female characters, and not just the young ones either. I think that the use of Joan Bennett and Alida Valli is really interesting and gives it is a woman's story.
E infatti non ci sono uomini nel film, non ci sono. I pochi uomini che ci sono sono, uno è cieco, un altro è, non parla, è muto, e il terzo è gay. E quindi praticamente non ci sono uomini, sono tutti rapporti di forza fra le donne.
Most of the students are women, are girls, and every man in the film is very ugly. Yes, and not strong, you know, and it's a film of witches, so it's completely feminine film.
Le donne, infatti il film, se si può fare una lettura un po' più profonda, si capisce che è un film vagamente lesbico, dove le lesbiche hanno un'importanza, cioè i rapporti fra le donne sono rapporti anche lesbici, dove c'è sopraffazione, eccetera.
You're pretty, very pretty indeed.
So what we're presented with is not women in film, but different modes of femininity. We've got the childlike girl.
But I can't stand to live in a boarding school like a 10-year-old.
These women are about 19, but clearly Argento wants them to be about 12, which is why the door handles are put high and why the girls are all quite flat-chested. The idea of ballet, which is a very youthful pursuit. And the other thing is that there is an intimacy, the girls' school, need I say more, where the nun has been replaced by the witch, which also resonates with late 18th century Gothic literature, where the abbess was the seducer and the creator of spells. And so the very notion of femininity is very ambiguous.
Però siccome all'epoca era un pochino molto più prude di oggi, quindi non ho potuto espletare completamente questo mio pensiero sul cinema lesbico. Mi dispiace molto di non averlo potuto fare.
There is a beautiful intimacy in the film, especially between Susie and Sarah. There's the scene where they're swimming and also the scene where they're just sharing their beds in the hall setup that shows it's a lesbian intimacy, but it's not one that is exploited. I think that a lot of the older women in the film who are witches are much more interested in seducing the young women as they are in punishing them. And the scene with Susie stabbing Helena Marcos in a bed, in a bedroom, in a darkened bedroom, and also the image of Sarah coming out with the nails in her eyes, it's like a jilted lover.
La donna ha il piacere di gettarsi nell'avventura. Io questo, quando ho capito, dopo il primo film, dove il protagonista era un uomo, e dopo che l'ho capito ho dato maggiore importanza alla donna. Oggi infatti non a caso nei miei film la maggioranza del pubblico è femminile, cioè il 60-70% del pubblico è femminile.
Despite the gender controversies which continue to surround the film and its director, Suspiria is now widely acknowledged as an important advance in horror cinema.
Sì, penso che sia un film che possa essere molto interessante, perché poi io l'ho fatto con un totale trasporto. Quando ho fatto il film mi sono posto un compito, che non avrei girato due inquadrature uguali in tutto il film. E questo è una cosa che al cinema non accade spesso, e quindi questo è una cosa che chi vuole studiare il cinema penso che sarà interessante, perché a me mi è costato tanto, tanto impegno veramente realizzare questa cosa, di fare di ogni inquadratura un unicum, cioè che non assomigliasse alle altre che avevo già fatto e non assomigliasse alle altre che dovevo fare ancora.
The film's complexity revealed the director's ambition to use every aspect of the cinematic medium to film fear at 400 degrees.
Fear at 400 degrees. I think he probably did do it. Because it's now a canon film, part of an accepted body of, you know, great horror movies.
I don't know if we could do the same now. Suspiria is magic. Suspiria is, there is something magic, magical in film and soundtrack.
Abbiamo fatto un lavoro molto, molto, molto duro, molto difficile. Oggi non si potrebbero più fare questi film, perché non ci sono più I soldi per farli. Un tempo era più facile farli, c'erano più possibilità, costavano di meno I film. Adesso non si può più fare niente di questo. Oggi sarebbe una cosa impensabile fare un nuovo Suspiria. So che stanno per rifare Suspiria, un remake, però non credo che riusciranno a farlo così, così inventato, così ricco.
One terrible thing I think at the moment in the film world is this obsession with doing remakes of films, whether it be horror or whatever.
Can it be remade? Well, yes, of course it can. Anything can be remade. Remakes exist for commercial reasons. Can it be remade well?
My feelings are I'd rather it doesn't happen, but if it does reintroduce an audience, who knows? Maybe if a young audience sees the remake, they will then want to see the original. And let's hope they do, so they can see how it should be done.